Greenhouse biodigesters. In this video, we are going to learn how to construct a biodigester using blocks. Now, we do have the various types of biodigesters that we construct for homeowners. We have the prefabricated slabs that we use. Some people also use bricks as well, but we are going to consider using blocks, and specifically the quarry type of block for this particular construction. So preferably the 5 inches. If you do get the 4 inches, it also works well. You are going to have to measure the ground. You are going to, in the first place, have to select and mark and prepare the site, and then you are going to have to dig the ground based on the measurement that you have decided. It can be a standard size digester, it can be a medium size, it can also be large family size or a commercial one, depending on the capacity of the property for which you are constructing the biodigester for. So if you do have that in mind, and then you have dug your ground and you have done your marking, then you know that you are starting with the construction. Obviously, the first thing is to do some concrete works at the base, and then from there you can start laying the blocks. You have to make sure that you use the rope. You are also using your spirit level and then your trowel, together with everything that comes with constructing a biodigester as a mason. Usually, I prefer those who will do the block work for you. If you are a constructor and you are not skilled in the masonry work of the block or bricklaying, then it's best you contract one to have it done for you, because the final finishing and the outlook of the biodigester is also key for you and the homeowner. The technicalities that involve to make sure that your digester stands firm and it stands the test of time is also key for you when you are constructing the biodigester and you are using blocks. In terms of your place that you'll be standing to do the concrete work is key. If it's a bit of a clay or the ground is not that good, and the best thing is to put some chippings on the ground, and then you can step on it so that it becomes firm for you. Later, when you are doing the screeding and you are doing the base work, mortar can be added to it just to firm the ground enough for your sloping of the gradient that goes into your lecher pipe. So that's very, very key for you. If it's a ground that you know is waterlogged, then I also ask that probably you can lay the black rubber polythene bag on the floor just to help the water that comes from the base or comes from the ground not coming to disturb and worry the biodigester. Remember, the key part when it comes to biodigester construction is making sure that the water table is something that you are matching it to. You are not hitting the water table so that water will not come into the digester. And then secondly, you do have enough gradient for the water go away if it does come into the digester. So in laying the block, you have to leave the outlet pipe, the lecher pipe, or the Soakaway pipe, the pipe that leads to the Soakaway pipe, make it available, and then leave the space there for the pipe to be done immediately after the first coat of the block has been done. It's key because you don't want to lay it all over before you come chiseling have it done. So it's important to put your pipe in. It can be a 3-inch pipe, it can be a 4-inch pipe. And the options, as has been discussed in some of the previous videos, the lecher pipe being directed is going into a Soakaway pit, or is going into a Soakaway, traditional Soakaway with the block work, or is simply going into a bigger drainage outside or a gutter where the wastewater which comes from a digester after filtration can go there for easy disposal. That's key for you. And the lecher pipe leading to the Soakaway pit or the Soakaway has to be at a gradient level so that any water that leaves the digester can also leave the slope, can take it all the way into the Soakaway or into wherever your wastewater or your black water is going. You are required to make sure the size is right. Ideally, the distance between the digester bed and then the Soakaway should be minimum of 4 feet away. The longer away it is, the better, But if you are economizing land, you are making maximum use of the land, 4 feet away is okay. 4 to 5 feet, 6 feet is okay, so that the digester is not affected by any water that might be worrying the ground where you are having the wastewater going to. If you are doing the drain flow system, then you will have to perforate the base of the leche pipe and then put some chippings on the leche pipe, the place that you have dug, for the wastewater to be directed through the drain flow pipe onto the earth surface. So in the normal circumstances, you will, depending on the inlet pipe that's coming, and then depending on the pipes, the gradient that you have in the house, the number of blocks or the layers of blocks that you go will be determined by the inlet pipe that will be coming. So for example, if you are constructing the biodigester using blocks, and then the pipe coming from the house is about 0.5 meters, you will be required to lay about 4 coats or 4 layers of blocks, so that the biodigester will go onto the third layer or the second layer, depending on the length or the level, and then the last coat, which is the fourth coat, will be the one that will show up for the final groundworks that will be done. Now, sometimes you can only lay 3 coats and then it's fine, because then the inlet pipe coming from the house is on the surface and the footing of the building is enough and it's good for you. So you don't have to drop it that deep for you to get the angle. And then since you are going to get 2 feet difference from the shape pipe and the inlet pipe, then you are good to go in that situation. Those are key technicalities that you need to know when you are constructing a biodigester. Sometimes if the homeowner asks you to construct a biodigester and probably you've not discussed with the plumber and you don't know the levels or the angles in which he's bringing the pipes, you can go and do the biodigester using the blocks, as lay your blocks and then do everything for it and don't leave pipes there for the plumber to come and connect, because probably when he's bringing it, either he falls at the base or he comes on top. You can just leave it for him. When he comes there, he can use the chisel and then get his hole done, and then he can drop in at the angle that will be good for him. Because I know people occasionally do some of the digesters and they do not get the level right. So when the plumber comes, he will tell you, the way you have laid the inlet pipe for me, my pipe will not meet it. So if you do not know the angle in which the toilet is coming from and you are not certain of the gradient level, just go ahead and do your digester. And when the plumber is ready, and chisel the inlet pipe for him and have it put in there for him. Dream House Biodigesters, constructors of biodegradable waste biodigesters in Ghana, and general home improvement. This is a channel dedicated to the construction of biodigesters, biodegradable waste biodigesters for homeowners who are looking at the option of using them for managing their human waste and their toilet waste water. How to construct a biodigester using blocks. So we do have the construction that we do with the precast slabs, and then we do have the construction that we do using blocks. If you are using the quarry dust blocks, usually what we ask is that you get the right type, which is the 5 inches. If you do use a 6 inches, it means that you have to resize the biodigester in such a way you have enough room in the digester bed so that you can lay your porous or your slab, your porous slab in the digester bed. Some people have also asked me why we do not plaster the inside of the biodigester, and I tell them, because you are using quarry dust blocks, sometimes it's not necessary to plaster the inside, because you are also making sure that you want the digester to breathe. Even though it's not using oxygen, what you are looking at is not to make the digester moist by rendering the inside. If the type of blocks that you are using is the ordinary sand one, then to make it firmer, then you can render and plaster the inside. Now, if it's a quarry dust block, after the laying of the blocks, it's okay. You can only render the outside and then render the top secure, and render the top slab to make sure it's secure to the biodigester. You are also remember that when you are constructing a biodigester, the other steps that you need to take: preparation of the so-called pit area for the black water. In this case, this particular one, the idea was plumber was going to connect it into a traditional Soakaway. The reason why now we do recommend the traditional Soakaway is because it lasts longer, it's safer for the environment. You are not going to have problems with your neighbors or anybody because you have gone to drop your black water in a gutter or in a drainage system and it's passing through somebody's house and the person is complaining that the scent or something smell is coming through their house. So the safe option most of the time now is to have the traditional Soakaway done, depending on the size, the 4 feet by 4 feet with a 5 feet or 6 feet depth, the 5 feet by 5, 6 feet depth, depending on the capacity of the building and the number of toilet rooms that are in the house. You can do the so-called pit or the Soakaway just to match that one specifically. If you do have a good land and the place is okay, and then you are going to consider a so-called pit, then make sure that you are getting the level right. The end, you are covering the end of the leche pipe with a vent cap, like I've shown in this previous video of how to construct a so-called pit the right way. You make sure that the screeding that you are going to do will be done in such a way that it leads all the way to the so-called pit or the Soakaway. The idea is that rapid separation must happen in a biodigester. The wastewater must be separated from the human waste. And the wastewater is what goes all the way into the Soakaway. The human waste stays in the digester. The biodegradation takes place and then it decomposes it, the human waste, and that's what can be easily disposed after a certain number of years. And people are in doubt and they wonder how does it happen. And we say that the reason why, when you say biodigester smells, and I argue and I say that it's not true, is because if you do separate the wastewater from the biodigester, human waste in the digester, that problem of having the smell, which happens usually in the septic system, will not arise. The reason why the human waste smells or it stinks is because the water is mixed with the human waste. And that one is what leads to the maggots and all the stuff that come with it. So we are going to just simply going to separate the wastewater from the digester. And that ensures that the human waste is what the microorganisms or the microbes will feed on. And then it works to the desired level in which we want it. So the screening is key for us in the sense that we have to make sure we get it right. We have to get the gradient right and the water must lead away. Any stagnant water in the digester is not good for the digester. And that one might cause the digester not to work well to the desired level. When you get to the desired level, probably in our case, the third coat, we do have the inlet that's for the house. So the inlet pipes are usually designed or they've been done in such a way that it's for the toilets that are coming from the house. It can be two, it can be three, or it can be four, depending on the type of digester and the type of property that you are having. The inlet pipes will then come and it has to be done at an angle where the plumber will bring the toilets from the house and come and connect them. You can decide to have several, two or three different inlet pipes in one digester. It doesn't matter the angle it's coming from. The idea is that you do not want the pipes to be running around the house all over to go and join each other. And that leads to the toilet getting stuck in the pipes. So sometimes if you do get two or three inlet pipes, the better it is. So there's nothing wrong with that if you have to do another inlet pipe for a biodigester apart from the original ones that you have done. And the inlet pipes must solely be done just for the pipes from the house to be connected to the biodigester. It must be held firmly in place in and out so that it doesn't shake and it doesn't affect the biodigester. And then you will have to
install the biodigester foster bed. Before preparing that one, make sure your gradient and the slope and the screeding is done, and then you firm inside the biodigester bed, and then you can put the biodigester floater bed, which in the first place is a porous floater bed, on the blocks in the digester. And depending on the type of digester that you have done, the size and the space that you get is where you put it in. Place the pervious concrete or the porous slab on the biodigester bed. The idea is that instead of using the wire mesh and stuff, now we do have slabs that we put inside the biodigester bed. These slabs are just for holding the load together, and it's for making sure that the wastewater seeps through them, and then we do perforate them, and then the wastewater seeps through them into the screeding, and then through the shape pipe into the Soakaway or the Soakaway. So that's why if you do have a digester and you are worried about or the type of chemicals or detergent that you use, no worry no more, because these are the water bed that we use now, and then you can take any type of detergent or bleach or parazone or akasha. It's not going to get corroded and it's going to work to perfection. So you lay them on a block just for the biodigester bed. Make sure it fits in. Your digester is 4 feet. A biodigester floater bed or the porous has to be less. It has to be 3 feet. So that when you do the measurement, then it will fit in perfectly. If it does not fit, you will have to do some chiseling for it to fit into the digester bed perfectly. You do lay them inside, and then you add the fiber net on top of it. Then you do add your fiber net, the coconut husk on it. Then you put the fiber material, the biodegradation material inside them. And this is how you prepare your biodigester bed using blocks. And then you cover it with the top slab, making sure that your inlet is not covered and there's enough coconut husk and fiber inside the biodigester bed. Biodegradation is going to happen by using this particular materials. You can then cover it with the top slab and then use mortar to seal it airtight. You do not need any vent pipe on your biodigester. The vent pipe must be on the building, and the vent pipes must be done for the building itself. The biodigester works in such a way that it does not need any air in terms of oxygen. It works in an oxygen-free environment, and it doesn't need any vent pipe on it. So in this particular case, as you can see, the Soakaway, the traditional Soakaway, is what has been attached to the digester, and the leche pipe has just gone into that particular Soakaway. And then we put a white inspection chamber, 4 inches one, on it, just for inspection in case the homeowner is using it and they have some doubt, they can open it and see the level or whatever it is that is inside. And then if there's any problem, the servicing can be done depending on what time. The next video that is coming up will explain to you into details how biodigesters work and how you can use it as an option in managing your solid waste and your human waste in your dream house.